Welcome, and today we'll learn about special characters in LaTeX. Here I have a very simple document. Document class is article. From the keyboard we can print many characters directly, okay? For example, equal sign, plus, minus, at, period, colon, semicolon, quotation mark, round brackets, square brackets, angle brackets, and vertical bar. Alright, as you can see that symbols are coming, except last three, open and closed angle brackets and vertical bar, these are not coming correctly, okay. So we can correct this using font encoding package. Just write fontent with the T1 option. Alright. From the keyboard some characters we cannot print directly, for example hash, dollar, percentage, ampersand, tilde, underscore, superscript, open and closed curly brackets and backslash. Using backslash before these symbols we can print these symbols. For printing backslash symbol we need to write backslash command. Otherwise it will produce one blank space, okay. Alright. Sometimes when we copy some text from the internet or some other sources, then LaTeX doesn't produce correctly. For example, here I have one PDF file and I'll copy this sentence. And I'll paste here. Here we can see that in the PDF file, dash symbol is not coming correctly. This one and this one. We can correct using input encoding package. In optional bracket, just write UTF-X. And in curly bracket, just write input int. Actually, it is UTF-8X. Alright, now it is coming correctly. I have here few more symbols from different sources. Degree Celsius, pound, section mark, registered, copyright, dagger, and trademark. Now again, as we can see that symbols are not coming correctly. We need to use this package, input tank. Alright, now these symbols are coming correctly. I want to use plus minus, I'll copy and paste here. We can directly use accented character. For example, I want to use. Alright. Remember that you need to use input encoding package with UTF-8X option. If you don't want to use copied symbols, then you can use LaTeX command. Just go to add this symbol and then go to add this place. From here you can choose the category. For example, if you want to use this one, then just click here. Suppose you want to use euro symbol, just type euro. I want to use this symbol. So for using this symbol, we need to use a text comp package. Any symbol you can get from here. For example, I want to use eta. I want to use this symbol. So this symbol requires MSSIM package. You need to write here MSSIM, and this one should be inside dollars. Alright, so you can get any symbols from here. You need to just write the name, okay. So these are the few tips for today's learning. That's all. Thanks for watching.